Even though DORA metrics were great, I think there was three problems that we identified. One, that there are like lagging indicators. Again, they prove a great point. If you're in good shape there, you're in good shape. But if you're not, now what? What do you need to do? So you need to go back to more like leading indicators and improve it. That's problem number one that kind of said, hey, we got to go beyond the DORA metrics. The second thing is that they lack business context. So I always compare this like to like an engine of a car. Let's say I execute amazing in all the DORA metrics. So like basically they measure like the cadence of delivery and the quality and everything is perfect. And I'm moving so fast, but I'm moving in the wrong direction.
Right.
Maybe still like, the company is saying, hey, you need to build A, but I'm moving towards like building B. Now I do acknowledge that if you're moving in short cycles, you identify it fast that you're moving in the wrong direction usually, but totally. Still it's like missed like the overall business context. So that's something else we wanted to add to that. And last but not least, I think like the third, I don't want to say it's flaw because again, it wasn't meant to break. DORA metrics are a great academic resource, but it's not like a product. But when we're building a product, we said, hey, if we want to really build a product around like improving this, the flaw that we have an operational plan, like how to improve. And then one missing piece is like the developers, because if you don't get the developers with a bottom up improvement that they care about the problems, you want to improve those like lead time for changes, deployment frequency, CFR, MTTR, everything else. So this is, those are like the elements that it was important for us like to put in there as part of like the engineering metrics initiative and other initiatives that we have in the company.